Is Monkey D. Luffy Yonko level? The question has been about in the One Piece fan base, similar to the skies above Onigashima. And I think the answer is without a doubt, yes. I think people are thinking about the question all wrong. It's more like, is Luffy Yonko class? I think what Oda's been working on for a long time now is warming us up to the idea that yes, Luffy is entering Yonko class. I don't think that means he can go 1v1 with Kaido locked in a cage for like a battle to the death for 2 hours straight, both of them completely fresh. But I think of it like this. It's basically like a handshake between emperors. I think the way Oda tries to portray the Yonko clash and the sky splitting is saying, can you even enter the conversation? Think about almost every single time we've seen the Yonko split the skies. To be honest, it wasn't in the middle of a battle where they was both almost worn out. It was from the very beginning. So is Luffy Yonko level? I think the answer is yes, he is in the same class. The more important question though is Luffy ready to meet Shanks? Shanks always said he only wanted to meet Luffy after he became a great pirate. And I think that's what he meant, an emperor level pirate. I think the first time Shanks seen Luffy again, he wanted to make sure he could do the emperor handshake, that he could split the heavens and say, you know, welcome to our level. This is the level you need to be on to even clash with us. I think Shanks always knew one day him and Luffy would have to battle, and he wanted to make sure Luffy was on the same playing field. So that's what I consider Yonko level. Can Luffy even enter the fight? If there was a One Piece tournament that only had emperor level people, the entrance exam would include the sky splitting. Like, they would have somebody out there who could split the skies and say, if you can't do this, then you can't even enter this competition. And now Luffy could enter the competition.
If you want to help me achieve my own Yonko level dreams, subscribe to my channel so you can follow me on my personal adventures to be Pirate King of YouTube, and like the video to help me beat the YouTube algorithm that the bigger YouTubers completely dominate.
The first time we see an example of the sky splitting is when Shanks enters Whitebeard's ship. He has a very important question to ask him about stopping Ace from challenging Blackbeard. Before he can get it out, Whitebeard jumps up and they split the heavens. They wasn't enemies, they have a rapport with each other. It was just a way of saying hello between emperors. One of the more recent examples we've seen was Kaido and Big Mom. We know that both of them know each other and they have a history together. And when Kaido seen Big Mom, the first thing he said was release her, and then they shook hands by splitting the skies. And that's how I like to think about it. I think the way that Oda is just trying to portray the sky splitting is basically a way to say hey to another emperor. Basically, all the emperors, even if they don't like each other, they respect each other for their strength. And if you can't split the skies, then you're not even worthy of their respect. And I think this can be shed even in the Odin flashback, one of the greatest flashbacks in anime history. Roger had immense respect for Whitebeard, and vice versa. Roger also knew he only had a year left to live, and it might be the last time he ever sees Whitebeard. So when they see each other, he made sure not to hold back. Whitebeard fell from the heavens, and Roger made sure he answered his almighty clash with one of his own. Not only did the heavens split, it almost destroyed the whole entire island. It looked like a hurricane hit it. I think he obviously will need more practice before he takes on Shanks, or really even could defeat Kaido in a 1v1 where they're both fresh and not worn out from battle. The last time we really saw Shanks, whenever he was looking at Luffy's wanted poster, and he said it's almost time. He didn't say it is time. He said, they're calling you a Yonko, but are you really Yonko power level? Because until then, I don't want to meet you. I don't care what the world says. We all know there's politics and stuff behind that, and territories and all these amazing feats you're done. That's very impressive. Yes, you have the will of an emperor, but do you have the power to back it up? And that's what Shanks was waiting on. So I think Shanks will actually meet Luffy very soon, maybe even when we leave Wano. I think the next place we'll probably go is Elbath, if not, but there's a mini arc between that. But I think ultimately the next major arc will be Elbath. And now finally, after all this time, if Luffy does finally get to meet Shanks and they get to clash and do the official Yonko handshake, Shanks will be like, welcome Luffy, you made it, you're now a great pirate. So do you think my Yonko handshake analogy is a good example of what it really means for the Conqueror's clash? Kind of like when you see an old homie and you got that handshake that only you and him know. Because friends or not, all the emperor level pirates always wind up knowing each other or having some kind of rapport, and I think they want to make sure they're still on that top level tier when they meet each other. Like, yo, you still got it in you, old friend? A good thing to keep in mind when considering this theory is that whenever Luffy and Kaido is about to face off for the first time on top of Onigashima, Kaido could sense Luffy's will and resolve, and he decided like, okay, this guy sensed like he could be another emperor, maybe he's Joy Boy, I'm gonna give him the emperor test. The only problem was is Luffy failed the test, and Kaido was so disappointed. I mean, he really thought he had another good challenger, and when Luffy failed to be able to clash conquerors with him and was not off the mountain, having to be saved by the law pirates, I mean, Kaido's face was visibly distraught. I think he doesn't really consider Big Mom an actual threat. I think he's stronger than her, and he was like, do I finally have another person who can battle out to be king?